shall come to me. She can lay here. It's okay.
Amen. But God, because of His Son, we are
believers, when we accept Him as Lord and Savior. So every day we have access asking Him forgiveness. Amen?
Amen.
So today I stand as a witness that God can change your life. Amen. And even when you're going through in the church, God can do a new thing. Amen?
Yes.
So I thank God today for the word of the Lord that He has given to me. And I thank God I already have a confirmation. So I'm going to read, amen, from the book of Jeremiah chapter 1. Amen. If you look at the program, you will see that it was this week's commentary lesson. Praise God. So I already smile because I feel at ease to bring this word. Amen. Jeremiah chapter 1, 5 says, "Before I formed thee in the belly, I knew thee. And before thou camest forth out of the womb, I sanctified thee. And I ordained thee a prophet unto the nation. Then said I, O Lord God, behold, I cannot speak, for I am a child. But the Lord said unto me, Say not, I am a child, for thou shalt go to all that I shall send thee, and whatsoever I command thee, thou shalt speak." And verse 8 says, "Be not afraid of their faces, for I am with thee to deliver thee, said the Lord." Then the Lord put forth his hand and touched my mouth, and the Lord said unto me, "Behold, I have put my words in thy mouth. See, I have this day set thee over the nation and over the kingdoms to root out and to pull down and to destroy and to throw down, to build and to plant." It's the word of the Lord. Amen. And I also want to read my main emphasis scripture is Ecclesiastes 10 and 1. And then I'm going to pray and dive in the word. Amen. "Dead flies make a perfumer's ointment give off a stench. So a little folly outweighs wisdom and honor." The New American Standard Version says, "Dead flies make a perfumer's all stink. So a little foolishness is weightier than wisdom and honor." The King James Bible says, "Dead flies cause the anointing, the ointment of the apothecary, to send forth a stinking savor. So doth a little folly him that is in reputation for wisdom and honor." The HCSB Holman Christian Bible says, "Dead flies make a perfumer's ointment ferment and stink. So a little folly outweighs wisdom and honor."
Amen. Amen.
I stand before you like Jeremiah, amen, to tell you that God says to tell you that flies is in the anointing. Tell your neighbor, flies in the anointing. Now, I want to warn you that my boxing gloves on, if you're going to challenge me. I want to warn you that I've got something in your TNC called the breastplate of righteousness on. I want to warn you that I'm on the helmet of salvation. In other words, then, I came dressed for battle. And I'm not contending with the flesh. There's a war in the spirit. And there's some flies that's trying to pollute the anointing. So it's from two scenarios here. Either God is saying to the church of the living God, because I'm speaking to you in the church, but this is a word over this region, because when God spoke in Genesis 1, it was a creative word. And He spoke to us dead and void. There were some flies on the earth, and He said it was causing pollution. It was causing death. It was stagnating what it was designed to be. Hallelujah. And so God said, one or two things. Either I'm going to protect what I have here, or there's some things that got to go.
Amen.
So there's two scenarios here today. You choose one or the other, or it could be both. In Northampton, New Testament Church of God, God is saying there's some flies in the anointing. Hallelujah. It says, "Look at Almighty, on March 10th, 2016, I just got up and was having my until I landed. I was told by Brother Ian Smith, we already booked you for the 10th and the 17th. So this word was given to me on March 10th, 2016. Glory to God. And God said, this is a word when you go to UK that you will preach it. I said, oh Lord Jesus. I've already been in trouble from the day I got saved. And now I'm old and mature in age. You know, I'm mother. Naturally, now I'm going to be in more trouble. But I understand that when John